See what he can do on his home field in his first start. Ambrose Urbanek Field. A beautiful 80 degrees tonight as we get closer to fall. Players taking a knee to recognize the fight for social justice, something they've done for a couple seasons now. David, how about the Jackson Walty haircut?
Yeah, I saw he got a nice tight cut for today, so we'll see what that means. The Iron Man of the Pitt Panthers with a fresh cut. Maybe he's trying to look a little bit younger.
It's been the talk of the Panther faithful is, you know, the evolution of Jackson Walty's haircuts over the 4 or 5 seasons he's been here. Now we got another one to add in there.
Going to be interesting to see how this game sets up. Pitt and White attacking from right to left. NC State coming up here in their away black kit, attacking from left to right.
Immediate quick strike up the right side, looking for Jacques Hasson, and handled easily by number 24, Cam Murray, the left back. Thought we might see Alex Bautista back in that position. Served a suspension earlier this week in the James Madison match after getting a red card last Friday against Wake Forest. But it is Murray in that left back position.
Yeah, it was a tough start to the ACC season for NC State last week. Not only do you get matched up having to go to Wake Forest, but Bautista was sent off after 15 minutes. They were forced to play a man down. They were also a goal down as the incident happened when Wake Forest had a penalty. So it was a tough start to ACC slate, and they'll be looking to make sure that they stay on level terms, not just on the score sheet, but in terms of the men on the field, and hold this Pitt team off as long as they can and see if they can get a result out of this game here at Pitt, which is a very tough place to play for anybody.
A couple of disappointing results on the schedule for NC State, of course, losing on their home field to James Madison earlier this week. Had a tough loss at number 4 Wake Forest a week ago. Obviously, that one not too disappointing. But before that, had a draw with Mercer, the Virginia Tech tournament that they hosted. All after winning their first 2 games of the season. Up the right side is Jeremiah Luoma, challenged. It'll be a Wolfpack throw-in.
Both of these teams have interesting streaks going. Pitt has not conceded a goal since September 2nd, and NC State has not scored a goal since September 2nd. So both of those streaks are on the line right now. Obviously, NC State will be looking to get on the score sheet, make an impact on this game. For Pitt, they'll be looking to keep them off the score sheet and maintain their shutout streak.
So far, NC State holding a high line. Nice ball into the center for Kelly. He chooses to strike this one high over the crossbar. So Kelly with an early chance to score.
That's a good sniff for Kelly. Nice to get a shot off early in the game, and they're going to need to be playing in Pitt's half of the field. Some good build-up play. Kelly knows what he wants to do. Get the shot off. He has led the line for this team. Obviously, he's got off to a hot start. But I know that Coach Kiefer will be looking for Luke Hilly and some of the other NC State players to get on the score sheet and make an impact on this game. He wants to see who his playmakers are going to be up on the top end of the field. And he's looking at different combinations of players to see who has good success and is able to build chemistry in their attack in third, in their opponent's half of the field.
Pedro Gosa, the captain, looking up the center. Pitt takes away possession. They'll launch an attack once again up the right side. Here's Jacques Hasson at the midfield stripe. Wants to take on the whole team. Tries to thread that ball through to Maiufo. It ends up over there. And finally, it's Lucas Hatzios picking it up. So Maiufo with some activity early on, David.
Yeah, getting his first start today. That's what scoring a goal at North Carolina will earn you. So scored the winning goal last week at UNC and earns his first start for Pitt today. I know that he was a late arrival to camp and a bit of an unknown quantity in terms of what he would be able to bring to this Pitt team. this season, but he's settled in really well after having kind of an abrupt start, and he's been able to settle in very well.
Jay Vidovich told us this week it's been hard to get him into training because he missed all of preseason. So he steps in and he's kind of learning as he plays games and gets minutes sparingly. So he's jumped into the starting lineup this quickly into the season. It's an impressive move for Maiufo.
Yeah, I wonder if he even knows how big a goal he scored last week. But, you know, getting on the score sheet at North Carolina and helping to earn Pitt's first ever win in Chapel Hill, I'm sure that meant a lot to his coach and his team. And probably they filled him in on just what a huge goal and what a huge win that was for this Pitt program.
And why don't we just add him to the French connection while we're talking about it. Frenchman himself, Pitt's top three, all natives of France. Here's one of them, number 10 in white, Bertrand Jacquesson. Sends this one into the box. There's Pedregosa. Great left foot to stop it. And finally, a brief clearance by NC State.
Yeah, Pedregosa slipped there too and was still able to make the clearance even while slipping and falling towards the ground. So nice big play by him.
Ball over to Maiufo. Tried to get creative with Almeida. Was knocked out. Ball in to number 11, Rodrigo Almeida. And Pitt wants to switch fields. Malti to Lucas Rosa.
Pitt's really going to be asking a lot of questions and seeing ways that they can break down this NC State back line. They're really going to be trying to stay compact and keep the spaces tight to not allow themselves to get broken down. Going to need to communicate very effectively and make sure that every movement has an associated movement.
It's a good ball into Noel. It ends up with Jacquesson. Now back post for Maiufo, and he just couldn't quite get there.
Jacquesson has really been putting in some nice crosses this season. I think that's one of the areas of his game that he's really improved, has been consistent in terms of putting that delivery in and finding the connection on the other side of the box there. It didn't quite come off, but they've had a lot of success through Jacquesson down that right-hand side this season. He's really been off to a hot start, and not just scoring, but he's got assists himself, and pretty sure he's third all-time on the Pitt assist chart, and can get himself up to second with one more tonight. So whether or not that's something he's conscious of, but he has really turned into not just a finisher and a goal scorer, but provider as well.
He was a guy that kind of sprung onto the scene as a freshman, had an unbelievable freshman year. Last year kind of got off to a slow start, found his way in the latter part of the season, and we asked Jay Vidovich, hey, what's different about Bertrand in the first handful of games this year as opposed to last season? And he said, you know what? He just convinced himself that he needed to work harder in the offseason, and it's paid dividends so far.
Yeah, it's amazing what hard work will do for you, but that's part of the maturation process with these college players is, you know, everyone kind of gets it at a different point in time. Everyone has different influences and motivations, and I think, you know, getting it to all come together is really the key, finding consistent performances, both as an individual and the collective. That's really the name of the game, and he's been much more mature. He's definitely been able to look at himself and see where he was lacking, and been working hard to address those areas, you know. Coach described the fact that he had an analytic brain and was really into video review. And he really wants to make it to the next level. And for whatever happened, he realized he needed to become a better player, work harder, and be a more complete player to make it to the next level. So he'll have a good shot doing that.
Jacquesson went to MLS Combine in the offseason and didn't perform the way he wanted to. And he looked around and said, you know, I have the ability to play better. So he's held himself accountable. One thing that Jay Vidovich has given him a lot of credit for is he's seeing fewer and fewer plays being taken off by Bertrand Jacquesson. He's defending up the field, making it easier on his teammates, and that leads to good opportunities to score the ball for him and his teammates up top.
Yeah, he's been working on the back end of the field too, and that makes a big difference to the overall performance, and it really all feeds into itself.
So after some early lengthy possession by NC State in the attacking half. Now it's been kind of all Pitt for the last few minutes. holding possession in a high line.
And I think for NC State, you're happy with the start to this game. It hasn't been too hectic. They've been able to put their foot on the ball a number of times.
Noel to Jacquesson into the box, and this one's wide right. He knows he just missed that one.
Good opportunity there for Pitt. They broke through the line. Jackson Walty plays the through ball to Noel, who's able to connect with Jacquesson. Just can't quite make the shot go. Goes near side, whereas we've seen him go far side, far panel a lot with those. So maybe he was trying something different, or maybe just wasn't able to pull off what he was doing. But a good start, and you want to get those shots off early to get yourself the confidence and work on honing in towards the goal.
Here's a look from behind the net. And there was a place to put that ball. He just missed it.
But I think you see the bright start from Jacquesson. He's been seeing a lot of the ball. And you can see Pitt's intent to attack not only down that right side, but down the left side as well.
NC State's focus coming in, David, for George Kiefer, the head coach, was, hey, we got to try and press them and try to contain that explosive offense. So far, Pitt playing with a lot of possession in the attacking half.
Yeah, Coach Kiefer was really interested to see how they were going to be able to handle Pitt's possession, if they were going to be able to stay organized. Wanted to know, can we make it difficult for them? And can we make it uncomfortable? And I think the longer they're able to settle into this game and gain a footing, possess themselves and turn their attack into the Pitt half, they're going to be able to ask more questions and really see if they can get some good goal scoring opportunities. I know that they're really looking to get Hilly going, who hasn't been able to get on the score sheet. Here he is.
Great shot from Hilly, curling to that upper left 90, just over the crossbar.
And that's another good look for the Wolfpack outside the box. So you see they're taking opportunities from range. Hilly cutting in from the right side. Makes a nice move and just misses the target, but that's a lot of good intent there. And it's been a bright start for NC State.
How do you like the setup, David, for NC State on the last couple goal kicks for Pitt? NC State standing right at the top of that 18-yard box, and it was two restarts ago that almost forced a turnover in the goalie box.
Well, I think teams know Pitt likes to play out of the back, and no one's going to be surprised by that. So teams are looking for it and expecting it and have strategies of their own to try to counter it.
Be a foul on the Panthers. Free kick for NC State in their own half. Hatzios plays it out left for Murray.
Cam Murray starting at left back tonight. He has started there a few times, but it was Batista that was there last week against Wake. But Murray's been good back there as well, and maybe that's a matchup issue against Jacquesson.
Hilly dancing with it, looking very active in the early portion of this game.
He's seen a good amount in the ball, but not a great pass there. It was behind Cleo. A bit frustrating there by the Wolfpack. They'll certainly be looking to avoid situations where they play themselves into trouble, and they'll need to limit their mistakes tonight.
Number 8, Will Butte, is back in the lineup tonight. There was some concern over him. He cramped up in the JMU game, but he's back at it. Here's a long ball up left for Murray. It's challenged there by Rosa for the Panthers. This ball in and kicked out by Almeida. Jeremiah Luoma taking on two Pitt defenders. And knocked away by Mayufo.
Both coaches that we talked to seem more concerned about what their teams were going to do in this game rather than the opponent. It seemed to be both coaches felt like it was in their hands based on what their teams did. I know that Pitt had a week of training this week, and Coach Vidovich was very excited about the fact that they had been able to get on the training ground this week. It's such a hectic start to the season. that it was really the first time they'd been able to work on things since camp. I know that Coach Kiefer's looking forward to being able to do the same next week when they don't have a midweek game. So really both of these coaches very focused on their team and how their team is going to act in certain situations.
Jarvis Cleal, the right back, working over there with Luoma. Yeah, David, I loved hearing from Jay Vidovich how excited he was to just get a full week of training with no midweek game. With only 10 days of preseason in college soccer, it comes hard, becomes harder and harder during the season to find opportunities to do that and fine-tune things. And he told us that the way the players reacted to training this week re-energized the coaching staff, motivated everybody. And I've never seen Jay Vidovich so excited to get back out on the pitch as he was this week talking about this game.
Yeah, it's amazing how you, as a coach, crave that practice time during the season because it does become more and more limited based on your schedule and managing injuries. A lot of times you can't get everyone on the field together at the same time, and you know there's a real value to that, so you want to be able to work on things, and sometimes the games come so quick that you don't have an opportunity to visit all the things that you need to work on. And so a week in the middle of the season is like gold to the coaching staff.
NC State will have a couple of those weeks coming up, as you said, David. Get a full week until they see Virginia Tech at home, and then another full week before they get Louisville at home again. So an opportunity for a kind of young NC State squad to get themselves centered, find the right combinations, move some personnel in and out. They also want to get Enrique Santos back, a guy who started 15 games a year ago. He's been out with an injury. Thought we might see him tonight, but he expects to come back next week against Virginia Tech. Here's Junior Nare in the center, challenged by Walty, and that'll be a foul. Free kick from that spot for the Wolfpack.
State's been causing problems for Pitt back there. You just saw Hilly was a target. Nare was able to gather up the clearance by Van der Sar and win the free kick in a dangerous position. Nare, to me, has looked like one of their most dynamic players. He's really got a lot of skill and pace. Young South African transfer from LaSalle. Nice attacking player. Pitt will need to be aware he is on the field tonight at all times.
Nare and Kelly over the ball. Now Nare will move into the box. So Connor Kelly will square this ball up for a set-piece opportunity for the Wolfpack. Scoreless, 17th minute of the game. Lining it back post. Look at Pedro Gosa trying to get a toe on it. That'll be a goal kick for the Panthers.
Pedregosa is going to be a big target on set pieces for NC State. They weren't able to connect with him there, but you could see who Connor Kelly was looking for. Kelly's got to be just loving life. One goal in 52 games for Duke, comes to North Carolina, scores five in his first few games. He's got to be loving life.
What'd you call him? A revelation for the Wolfpack?
Absolutely.
This is a team that hasn't had a goal scorer of over six goals in the last few seasons. So for Kelly to have five already is astonishing. They really need him to keep producing at that level, though. It can't tail off, or this team's going to have a rough go of it.
Yeah, I mean, he doesn't just need to score the goals himself. If he can help the team create goals, if he can bring confidence to the squad, and that's what Coach Kiefer talked about, the fact that he was exactly what they needed, and he's such a great person, embraced the group. Obviously, he's got a lot of ACC experience, and so with so many young players on this NC State team, he's really going to help them deal with the rigor of the ACC schedule and, you know, help take some of the pressure off at different points in time. You see he's very active in that attack and central midfield position.
Turns it over there. Here come the Panthers.
He's definitely a worker. It fits in with this up-tempo effort of the Wolfpack. They like to chase down everything and put a ton of pressure on the ball when they're able to, looking to cause turnovers.
Pitt back line. Mohamed Abulnadi, Enrique Galina, Jackson Gilman.
And you see how high up the right-hand side Lucas Rosa, the right back, is there. A lot of times Pitt does shift to kind of a back three and launch their right back up the field like an attacking right back. It gives them an extra option there. Been quite a while since Pitt conceded a goal.
Mirkovic, great ball. Noel with space, centered up, and there's Hatzios.
Good breakthrough by Noel there, but he wasn't quite able to find the middle of the park and get connected to Almeida in there. Great start to the season by Noel, though. He's really been, I think, playing with a lot of confidence, inspiring his teammates, leading from the front. He's got a great work rate, a great engine.
Couple good combinations and passes in the early going here, Dave, and here's another one for Pitt.
Yeah, it's a nice kind of no-look pass there by Mirkovic. Noel's not quite able to bring it back enough to find Almeida, but Hatzios does a good job cutting it out as well.
Back-to-back Coastal Division champions, Panthers, picked to win it once again. Picked third overall in the conference this year. NC State on the other side, picked to finish last in the Atlantic Division. That was where they finished last season. Cleal, challenged by Walty, gets rid of that ball.
Yeah, you get the feeling the Wolfpack might have something to say about that. I don't think they plan on finishing sixth this season. But starting out their ACC slate against Wake Forest and Pitt, Coach Kiefer described as, in football terms, like going to Georgia and Alabama, your first two conference games. So they've definitely been handed a tough ACC start. But there's plenty of games on the slate, and if they can get something out of this one, it'll really buoy them to move forward with their season.
First corner of the match, and they do a short start and bring it back out to midfield.
So we're already halfway through the first half, and I would think NC State's going to be the happier of the two teams. They've been able to really put together a number of quality minutes. They have been tested, but I think they've asked some serious questions of Pitt as well. But here comes Mirkovic with the run. Couldn't quite connect with Almeida.
Great run up the middle with speed from Mirkovic. Almost waited maybe a bit too long to send that off, David.
Yeah, he was charging through the midfield. A couple guys stepped to him, but once he got past the initial rush, he had 40 yards of turf to run into. Just couldn't quite connect with Almeida. But that was the type of run that Pitt needed to turn the tide a bit. I feel like NC State's been able to get a good foothold in this game, and Pitt hasn't done enough to disrupt them. Haven't really seen Pitt possess the ball the way that they like to.
Walty, quick restart right after the foul. Lucas Rosa up the right side. Jackie Son tucking in. Now it's centered back up. Good ball from Mayufo. Run from Almeida, and look at that challenge up the center as Noel once again and Pedregosa marked him.
Great defending by Pedregosa. Knew exactly what Pitt was trying to do there and was able to cut out the cross. Mayufu is able to thread it through to Almeida. Turns and puts it across. You could see Noel was the target.
First corner of the match for the Panthers. Sent in near post and knocked out by NC State. Kendall Edwards, the captain, is able to get that out of there.
Now you see Pitt having a bit more of a period of possession. doing a bit more probing. It's going to be important for NC State not to switch off for a second. As well as they're doing so far in this game, Pitt can hurt you very, very quickly. And so it's important that NC State stays compact, stays strong, keeps forcing Pitt back, and chasing down everything that they can.
This trio of Abelnati, Galena, and Gilman doing a nice job of shifting that NC State defense. Jackson Gilman, the freshman, coming off a co-defensive player of the week honor. Came down on Tuesday. Gilman, talk about a revelation for a team. Relation to Connor Kelly for NC State, and we'll get back to that in a second. Mayufo with a chance here. Jackson on a volley, knocked away by Hatzios. How did he get there?
I judged it just right. Was able to get on the end of it for a volley. Great save by Hatzios. Quick build-up play by Pitt. Mayufo's released. Finds Jackson at the back post. Doesn't look like he got a clean hit on it, but the goalie does good to get over and stop it from going in the
goal. Corner opportunity. Headed out once again by Edwards. Said Pitt can strike like lightning, and that thing came out of nowhere. Great chance for Jackson. Here's Mayufo trying to head it in and wide left.
Good opportunity created by the Panthers. You see them kind of going at it a bit more intently now. A couple big diagonal balls. It's Mirkovic delivers. Good cross. Mayufo's just not able to put the header on target. But a good opportunity. George Kiefer got to be happy with his team's start. I think they've been really bright, energetic. Obviously, it's going to be important for them to hold their lines throughout this game. We'll see if the midweek game plays a factor. Lost to James Madison on Tuesday. It was a hard match. I asked Coach Vidovich if he thought it might help his team, the fact that NC State had played midweek and suffered the loss. And he just said, you never know. You know, it doesn't really matter. And while there could be some fatigue on their part, you know, they get some players back that may have been injured. They got Batista back, who was suspended for that game. And there were moments in that game that they did very, very well, so they could have been buoyed by elements of that performance.
Great individual fight by Almeida to maintain possession through the midfield, but turns it over eventually with the pass toward Jackson, and NC State resets. Hilly with a soft touch. And back to Vandersaar.
Hilly and Kelly have done well up top for NC State. I know that Hilly's looking for his first goal. Coach Kiefer talked about the fact that he's had a lot of chances, but he really needs him to open his account. He's excited about managing him, but like all number nines, all strikers, you need to score to really feel good about yourself and what you're doing. And obviously coming in with some hype as the ACC preseason player to watch for NC State. You know, sometimes players put some pressure on themselves and scoring becomes a little bit harder, but it's not through a lack of effort on his part by Hilly, and maybe tonight will be the night he gets a breakthrough. But he's had a couple big assists and he's definitely been helping his team, even if he hasn't been able to get on the score sheet himself.
George Kiefer said, you know, number nines are kind of tricky. All they want to do is go ahead and go forward and score. But they've been working with Hilly as well to work on his hold-up play, work on his defense. Good combination of passes in the box and toward the net by Noel once again. Not much on that one, and an easy stop for Hatzios.
Noel there turned and had a shot, and I think he realized after he might have been better off laying it off to Rodrigo Almeida there, who was standing just on the top of the box. But Pitt's getting a bit frustrated, I think, and looking to break through, so they're going to need to stick to their game plan and not play outside of themselves.
Good ball and a charge here for Nare. Will Butte out wide here to Jarvis Cleo. And it'll be a corner for NC State.
Nice build-up play there. Butte playing it out to Cleo. Nare picks out Luoma, is able to drop it back here. And you see nice connected passes there and asking some questions and winning themselves a corner. So that's exactly the type of build-up play NC State will be looking for. And now they'll see if they can capitalize off this corner.
Connor Kelly squares it up. Into the air, and Mirkovic is able to head it out. Now Mayufo with a long challenge. He has a head of steam, and he's taken down. There's a whistle. Pablo Pedregosa. Lucas Rosa getting into it. There's a card on Pedregosa.
Yeah, some spiciness for us. We knew this game was going to be a bit helter-skelter.
Head referee David Urbacher is going to go to the monitor for a review.
And so we'll see if anything happens here. I don't know if they're looking to see if he threw an elbow there or if there's something more to it, but I didn't see an elbow there. But the Wolfpack fell victim to VAR last week. Batista's red card came during a reviewed incident. It was while the penalty was being taken by Wake Forest, and there was an incident on the top of the box as the teams were waiting for the penalty kick to be taken.
Quick decision here.
Coach Kiefer talked about that they'd had a lesson in VAR. I think he's confirming it's a free kick for Pitt. So nothing of malice there. I think it was a hotly contested play. Yes, it's a foul. Yeah, the push in the back gets you a yellow card. But there was nothing more to it than that. I like the contention that he won the ball, but that's what you want. You guys at least think they won it, but didn't think he got a lot of it.
Pedro Gose has played every minute this season. 54 career starts for NC State, and a four-year player and a captain.
Senior from Villarreal, Spain, played his club ball for CD Castellón over there, not far outside of Valencia.
Jacques Son working on Nare to Mayufo. This one somehow got through. Now it's loose in the box, and NC State is able to punch it out.
Cleo wasn't really able to deal with it in his right back position, and Mayufo almost got himself a chance there. Nice work down the right hand side by Jacques Son to provide the service.
Trying to combine again. That French connection at work.
Look how many black shirts there are back in the box, jamming up the lines. It's tough for Pitt to find any going forward there. NC State doing such a good job of getting behind the ball, defending their goal.
No whistle there as Jacques Son was taken down.
Great feat here by Jacques Son. I can only dream of pulling off a move like that, but he's able to beat his man and deliver the ball. I think Mayufo was a little bit surprised the ball got to him. but great work down there. Good service provided by Jack Aison.
First substitutions of the game. Noe Cabezas on for Connor Kelly. Callum Tommy, another South African player, comes in for Junior Nare.
So some fresh legs with about 13 minutes to go here in the half. Nare and Kelly both have worked extremely hard, so I'm sure they'll be grateful for the extra rest going into halftime. And I think for NC State now, they'll be able to see if these fresh legs can turn the screws to Pitt a bit, see if they can expose some flaws or take advantage of the fresh legs.
That'll be Pitt possession, midfield.
Coach Keefe has been really happy about how his NC State squad has been coming together. He really likes his group. They're definitely gaining an understanding of what's necessary, especially so many young players working in to this squad.
Mirkovic, look at this ball to Jack Aison. An unbelievable stop from Hatzios coming up off his line.
And there was a flag in there for offside.
Yeah, I did see the flag come up.
But Jack Aison burst through there with real speed. Abel Nardi plays it through. Mirkovic again looking for the through ball. Keeper makes a nice save. Hatzios. You know, NC State's been looking at two goalies throughout the season. Wyndham Ellis as well started a couple games and done quite well, but it looks like Hatzios is the guy who's earning a bit more of the number one. He's a guy that's been in youth national team camps with the U.S. youth set up at under 14, under 17 level. So you know that there's a lot of quality to him. And he's been getting some good experience this year.
You asked George Kiefer, how are you evaluating that rotation at the goalkeeper position? He said, I'm just letting them figure it out. And really, he's just looking for who's the best in critical moments. And that was one right there for Hatzios.
Yeah, they've had a bit of a rotation going on, but I'm not sure that that will continue, but we'll see. So Hatzios has certainly done well so far tonight and helped them figure it out.
So back to the chance by Jack Aison in just a moment. Looking for the offside here. Ball's touched at that moment. And they call Jack Aison offside. I don't know, David, what do you think?
It don't really matter what I think.
The people want to know.
Yeah, I mean, you know, looked like he maybe was onside, but he was, you know, the closest player to the AR. And sometimes when you buzz by your guy quickly, it looks like you're offside. So I don't know.
Fair enough. Skewed angle.
Yeah, I want to see the triangulation of the lines.
I'll let you off easy.
Adam
Don't
Olson.
Worry about it. I won't put you on the spot again. This ball into the box. They are hammering away trying to find Valentin Noel, get him his fourth goal of the year.
I've enjoyed this game so far. There's been lots of action, both ends. Both teams are really digging in and I think challenging each other to break down their opponent, to find the weak points, to be able to make a play, to outmaneuver someone, outmuscle someone, outthink someone. And so it's really there for the taking. NC State, I think, will be happy with how things have gone so far. Obviously, they need to continue to keep a clean sheet, keep Pitt off the board, and see if they can create opportunity for themselves as they move through this game. But I think they've been very well organized. They've defended very well, and they've created good opportunities for themselves.
I mean, if you look at the Wake Forest game, obviously they were outshot 15-1 and they go down a man 15 minutes into that contest, but they were able to maintain a decent score in that match for the for basically the duration, only losing 2-0 to Wake Forest, number four team in the country at the time. George Kiefer told us he was happy with how tight the lines were defensively. They were organized in that match to limit the damage against Wake Forest being down a man in the 15th minute.
Yeah, and I think that's what you're seeing from this North Carolina State team is, you know, they are solid at the back. They do have good goalkeeping. You know, they do have good young players and some strong midfielders. So I think it's really a matter of how are you going to score goals, how are you going to combine. And I know that Coach Kiefer's looking for the right combination of players, and you see some of those changes here tonight to try to keep the pressure up on Pitt, but also give them a different look. But here's the danger when you try to take it to Pitt. It leaves more space, and you leave yourself vulnerable to their explosive offense.
Mirkovic off the crossbar! What an attempt from Filip Mirkovic.
Yeah, he drilled that and was unfortunate not to score. The goalie was saved by the crossbar.
It's curling in back post, upper 90.
And that is definitely Mirkovic's preferred way of scoring. He loves those rockets from outside the box. Has a fierce pile driver of a shot. And we've seen him pull those ones off a number of times. So a bit of a let off there for Wolfpack. Let's see it again. No one steps to him. He knows what he wants to do. He's about to launch it. Puts his foot right through it. Just a little bit too much loft. Goalie does tip it onto the crossbar. So
yes.
Credit to Hatzios for getting fingers to it. Because that thing might have found its way in the net without that intervention by the goalkeeper.
Yeah, I agree. I think it was going in. So Hatzios in another critical moment. Times that ball well enough to save a goal just before halftime.
Mirkovic gets a card for that foul. Everything hotly contested, as we knew it would be. Certainly NC State coming in here as the underdog, but they've scrapped for everything so far today.
There's Jay Vidovich, haven't taken a look at him yet. Sitting on 99 career ACC wins. A win tonight could make him the first coach ever in ACC history to reach 100 wins. It's a heck of a list he's on there. Obviously, Sasho Sarovsky's been out of the conference since 2014 when Maryland moved to the Big Ten. But an accomplishment nonetheless if he's able to pull it off tonight.
And we know Coach Vidovich was expecting a helter-skelter game tonight. I think it has been somewhat, but it hasn't been frantic, I don't think. And while the teams have played quick, they haven't seemed rushed. He wanted his team to make sense of the nonsense and pressure when they can. I think they've done a good job of that. But they haven't been able to press for as long as they've wanted to. They haven't been able to sustain pressure in the Wolfpack half of the field the way that they would have wanted to.
Talk about the all-important first goal for the Panthers. Under Jay Vidovich, his seven seasons, Pitt is 54-6-2 when they score first.
Jack is on working down the right-hand flank again.
Lined in, deflected off of Pedro Gosa. Be a corner kick for the Panthers. Corner number four. Pit up 6-2 in the shot department.
Coming into this game, NC State had been out-cornered 30-14 by their opponents, so they do tend to give up quite a few corners, and that does provide the opposition with set-piece attack and threats.
This one headed out.
Come on,
Credit to NC State. Defending well. Pitt has scored three or more goals in 16 of 25 home games. 16 of their last 25 home games. So to keep them at bay for almost 45 minutes is an accomplishment.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Pitt's been so good here. Ambrose Urbanek Field. They're used to winning here.
Some of the numbers are ridiculous. Since 2019, a plus 63 goal differential, 24-1. And then defensively sound as well. Allowed two goals or less in 20 straight matches here.
See Josh Lucchini coming in there for Matteo Malifu. Lucchini, graduate transfer from Lehigh, local boy out of Wexford. He'll be looking to make an impact on the score sheet tonight for Pitt.
That was Noe Cabezas trying to combine with Callum Tommy. Now here comes a counter, a 3-on-4 for the Panthers. Almeida pushing. Rodrigo Almeida to Valentin Noel. Tapped out wide to Josh Lucchini. Now Mirkovic, left foot strike, way wide and high. Great coverage by the NC State back line.
Yeah, I think that's an example of Pitt getting frustrated. You see the breakaway opportunity there, but NC State has too many players back. They cut off the passing lanes. You got players back behind the ball. And you see they're right on you. I think Mirkovic takes a shot on a foot he doesn't want from a place he doesn't want. So it's not the opportunity Pitt's looking for. But I think that's an example of Mirkovic being frustrated by not getting what he wants or seeing what he wants, being able to connect with his teammates effectively. And a credit to the Wolfpack defending in this first half.
Pitt with three shutouts of their own this season. It's a big credit to the, you know, the big stories, David, coming into the season was how was Pitt going to replace four starters on the back line? And they've done that relatively seamlessly. Here's a ball in and headed out. I was talking about this earlier in relation to Connor Kelly being a revelation for NC State. You can say the same of Jackson Gilman, a true freshman for Pitt, sliding into all four of those backline positions and keeping that defense sound for the Panthers this season, picking up off of last year.
Yeah, and even though Pitt has a lot of experience on their side, they also have a ton of new faces, where two-thirds of their roster are new faces that had never put on a Pitt shirt before this season. So I think that, you know, this back line and some of the new faces have answered a lot of questions in regards to what they can do for Pitt, and I think you've seen a lot of them working their way into the team.
They've dealt with some injuries there too. Transfer Giannis Learman, a four-year player at UCF. He's banged up a little bit. He started every game. Now a ball, right post, and just wide again. The Panthers are wearing out the right side of that net. Just none of them for goals.
Yeah, I think it's been, you know, a really bright first half by both teams. Both teams asking questions of each other, being forced to defend and execute their game plans. So I can't wait for a second half.
Panthers 9-2 in the shot department. Still scoreless at half, David. Thoughts on the
second half's really set up for your typical solid ACC thoroughfare.
It's just another day in the ACC.
Yep.
This one's a grinded out affair. The theme for NC State this year, their word of the season set forth by George Kiefer, is grit. Pittsburgh knows a little something about that word. Whichever team has more of that in the second half is likely to come out on top.
Yeah, we have really seen a lot of grit from NC State. And I'm sure the second half will be much the same. Does not look like Connor Kelly is starting the second half, as I see Noe Cabezas is still out there. So a slightly different look from NC State start the second half.
Callum Tommy is out there as well still. So I believe this is how NC State went into the locker room with this formation and lineup. There's a foul on Pitt deep in NC State's half of the field. It'll be a free kick for Hatzios there.
It's too bad we weren't able to interview the coaches today. I would like to have heard what their halftime team talks were going to be like. Here, Walty really coming out strong, trying to pressure that ball off Kendall Edwards.
Jackson Walty coming into this match with over 7,500 collegiate minutes played. Came into this program as a walk-on. As Jay Vidovich said, once the door opened for him back in 2018, he never let it shut. He's been the poster child, basically, for this team. Basically is synonymous with Jay Vidovich and the turnaround that exists for this program. Jacques Song dancing with it and taken down. Murray doesn't like the call.
Murray making the argument that he won the ball. Referee saw it different.
Jacques Song just so dynamic.
He's
turning Murray multiple times.
Cam Murray's had his hands full with Jacques Song tonight. He stood up to the challenge so far. Might be seeing shadows in his sleep a little bit, but maybe not. You know, maybe he's going to get the better of him today and hold this Pitt team off the board.
Dangerous position for a free kick from Filip Mirkovic. Some jostling going on in the box. Lucchini and Hilly getting into it. Smiles on both their faces. Good old-fashioned ACC soccer. Mirkovic, the sophomore, sends it in. This ball is in the back of the net, and the Panthers go up 1-0.
And I think it is Josh Lucchini connects with the header. The Mirkovic free kick came over. Josh Lucchini found a way to get it into the back of the net. Get himself on the score sheet for Pitt for first time. Let's take another look at the free kick by Mirkovic. Henrique Galina also going up on it, but it's Lucchini that gets the cleaner connection. There it is, heads it down, the goalie jumps over it, and it's in the back of the net. And look at that ecstasy by Josh Lucchini, and that's the breakthrough that the Pitt Panthers needed.
Lucchini and Hilly were jostling just before that kick. Lucchini wins the battle for his first goal as a Panther, first of the year, and his 26th of his career. 25 of those, of course, coming as a member of Lehigh, transferred into the program this year, and a hometown kid out of Wexford.
Great start to the second half for Pitt Panthers. Exactly what they would have been looking for, the reaction the coaching staff would have been looking for. For NC State, that's a real blow to concede early in the second half after doing so well, defending so strongly in the first half. Now they got to get back to it and continue to defend, continue to hold them off, and continue to fight and work to give their team a chance to get back on level terms. This is where the learning comes in and the big tests to see what your team has, what they learn, how they're able to handle these situations and the adversity that the game provides.
And it all started with the dynamic play of Bertrand Jacques Song as well. Dances with the ball, draws a foul. Dangerous position for a free kick, and Pitt capitalizes on the set piece. Mentioned earlier, Panthers are unreal when they score first under Jay Vidovich. The last seven seasons, 54-6-2 when they score first, 29-0-2, unbeaten since the beginning of the 2020 season. And they go up 1-0 within the first 3 minutes of the second half, and that's how you come out of the locker room.
Yeah, I think you could see the intent was there. I mean, even as soon as Walty gave up that foul on Kendall Edwards, but you could see the intent of how they were looking to up the tempo a bit and really be able to create more chances or put more pressure on the Wolfpack. Here you see the goal again. Lucchini's got it measured the whole way. NC State can't keep it out. And Lucchini's on the board for the Panthers.
We thought he'd be a major addition to this roster. And for Lucchini, he's just had some issues with injuries, missed the first couple of games of the season, took a knock in the preseason. His season high in minutes is 54, and that's not something he's used to doing, being such a staple of that Lehigh offense for the last 4 years.
I think that's one of the really difficult things about the college soccer season is it comes and goes so quick. I mean, it's really maybe 3 months from start to finish. Lucchini picked up an injury when he got his foot stomped on. And so, you know, you can lose a week, 2 weeks, and before you know it, you've lost 4, 5, 6 games out of a season, and it can be devastating. So I think it was important for him to get back on the field, and it's going to be important for him to find his health and maintain it, as it is for all of these players, to really stay healthy over the course of the season. But as we talked about with Hilly last year, suffering injuries mid-season after getting off to a really hot start, you know, it's hard to get back to that form and continue to just tap into that that hot streak. So you've got to be able to find your form, find that consistency, and obviously staying healthy is a massive part of it.
Panthers are not going to go away anytime soon. Rosa was trying to thread the needle for Almeida. Now launching the counter was Luoma. Callum Tommy over there taken down. George Kiefer regards Tommy as the fastest player he's ever coached. And it looks like since he's come on late in the first half, they've been trying to go up the right side to him when they do have a chance for a counter. Josh Lucchini came on late in the first half as well and started the second half and is quickly rewarded. He's only played 9 minutes in this match.
Well, it was a really big goal for the Panthers. We'll see if they're able to build off it. But you could tell they were desperate for that breakthrough, and NC State was really frustrating them in that first half. And so I think it's a real blow for the Wolfpack to give up that goal early in the second half. And now they'll be challenged by the adversity to see if they can dig in and continue to defend well and see if they can get themselves on the score sheet. As long as it's 1-0, they're right in this game. And as I said, they've been doing very well. So it's just a matter of keeping the energy up, keeping your work rate up, and minimizing mistakes.
Jackson Gilman. Now to Jacquesson. Pitt's attack looking a little bit more methodical now with a 1-0 lead. Not in as much of a hurry to launch an attack.
It's probably a case of halftime was probably the last thing that NC State wanted or needed. You know, sometimes when things are going good, that halftime whistle can be the worst thing for you because, you know, you got time to go in and think about what's going on, or the other team has time to go in and reset. And so I think Pitt's definitely come out the brighter the second half, and they've earned themselves their goal by turning the screws a bit, and the Wolfpack have become a little bit more unhinged by that goal, obviously.
That was a crucial mistouch by Luoma trying to feed Tommy and allowed the Panther defense to get back to the ball. This one punched out by Vandersaar. It's loose. And Pitt does a nice job of regaining possession for the moment. Now back in the Wolfpack hands. Great tackle from Abelnati. It'll be a throw-in.
Good ball played across earlier there by Luoma as well. Forced a save by Van der Sar, who was able to parry it down. We'll see if fatigue plays a factor in the second half for NC State, given that Tuesday night game, or if they're able to muster the energy to get the goal and get back in here. You see the play where Luoma crosses it over. Van der Sar stops it from going across the box. That's the type of work rate the Wolfpack are going to need. But Van der Sar has done a good job of protecting his net all season long, and he'll be looking to put up another shutout tonight.
Third corner of the match coming. Cabezas to take it. He's looking for Pedro Gosa. Now Bertrand Jacquesson with a head of steam tries to put it over the keeper's head and just misses.
Wow.
You got nothing else to say there.
Well, I mean, I was wondering if he was going to try it, and I didn't know if he was just going to try to make a break for it, but he sees the goalie off his line. Had it measured, just didn't quite have the target correct. But the distance was there, and you could see what he was trying to do. Lobbed the goalie from 50 yards out.
He had Noel running with him as well, so I wasn't sure if it was going to go to the net or go across the field.
I mean, the things we've seen Bertrand Jacquesson do, it wouldn't have surprised me at all for him to, you know, put that in the back of the net and not look, make it look very simple in the process as well.
David, it looks to me like he's playing on that right side tonight. Foul here, free kick for Pitt. But it looks like Jackson's missed wide right more than a couple times tonight. Just missed striking that ball.
Yeah, he hasn't quite been able to find the target tonight, but he'll keep looking for it. And I'm sure he'll have a couple more opportunities to find the net. But I think as much as anything, that's a credit to the pressure that NC State's put on some of these Pitt attacking players. They've really disrupted them, made it difficult for them to play their passing game, possession game that they want. And they've really prevented them from having clear goal-scoring opportunities.
Looking for Jacquesson again. That squirted through the legs of Murray, and he lined it up. That was Lucchini running up again.
Nice opportunity created there as Gilman with the long ball is able to pick out Jacquesson. He wins a tussle with Murray and plays the ball across the box. Lucchini trying to catch up with it, wasn't really able to get a good shot off. That's a really nice ball across the box. Just Lucchini's leaning back on it too much.
Jacquesson one shy of second on the career assist list in Pitt history. Last year was fifth in Division I with 11 assists, which was a program record.
There you see him keep working, gives up a foul, but he's trying to win the ball back. I think that's an example of maybe something that wasn't in his repertoire a couple years ago, that kind of tenacity, that Pittsburgh grit. When he loses the ball, making all that effort to win it back, even if it does cost you a foul. Continues to put pressure on the opposition. And I think that's one of the things that we've seen Pitt do in this second half is raise their energy and really try to take it to NC State.
Here's Mirkovic off the great touch from Noel. Feeds Lucchini. Centered up for Rosa. Great touch again. Noel lining it up. Hatzio saves that ball. Great combination passes from the Panthers to get a chance for Noel.
Nice opportunity created there. Rosa is able to thread the needle through to Noel. One touch and turn. Hatzios, another big save. Gets his paw behind it and gathers up the rebound. Good effort by Noel. Keepers up to the challenge. And that's a huge save because it keeps NC State within one goal of this Panther team. Talking to Coach Vidovich, their only loss on the season so far was down at Marshall. He talked about the fact that they didn't bring enough energy. They didn't bring enough mental intensity. And I think that those are some of the adjustments that this Pitt team made at halftime, stepping up their energy level, stepping up their intensity, and really making sure that they didn't regret not bringing their A game into this matchup tonight.
Back to Breton Jacquesson for just a moment. And talking about Jay Vidovich, what was different with Breton last year? You see the first seven games last season, only one goal, was out of the starting lineup, only 56 minutes a game. This is after becoming the ACC Freshman of the Year a season before this. And then in the last 13 games, he found his form. 6 goals, 11 assists, which was a program record. And this season, just the first 6 games, 3 goals and 3 assists. So the difference is noticeable, not only for production standpoint, but on the field when you watch him.
Yeah, there was a lot of intangibles that were noticeably improved with him. I mean, obviously the work rate, the tenacity, the desire, but also the quality, you know, the speed. He seems quicker, he seems stronger, he seems more accurate. The crosses, the passes, it's just really impressive the improvements he's made to his game and the effort he's put into doing that.
A couple of subs came on for NC State. Hilly leaves for Drew Lovelace. Bautista back on for the first time since the Wake Forest red card. He replaces Luoma and Connor Kelly back in. As Plamana will head out. College soccer, you can re-enter once in the second half, so we'll see a number of those guys again, I'm sure.
Yeah, and you see NC State looking to freshen up the legs. We're 15 minutes into the second half now, and they want to keep their legs fresh and keep working hard to stop Pitt from executing their game plan. Continue to jam them up.
NC State winless on the road since the start of 2020. In conference play. Haven't been here since the 2019 ACC tournament quarterfinals, where they took the Panthers to overtime and Edward Kiza shut the door on them with a golden goal.
Yeah, that was the last time these two teams played. That day, Kendall Edwards and Pablo Pedregosa were playing for NC State. Walty and Valentin Noel are the only holdovers from the Pitt side. So four guys on the field from that 2019 matchup.
It's just so interesting how quickly time changes as well. That was 3 seasons ago. Pitt at the time, first ever ACC semifinal appearance, and you think of what they've done in the list of firsts that's grown since then. That was Jay Vidovich's 4th season, and that's when they finally started to gain momentum. His recruiting classes were injected into the roster, and 3 years after, you look at what they've done, gone to a college cup, a round of 8. It's just unbelievable the way that this has gone.
Well, and I'd say that NC State is one team in particular that Pitt seems to have taken their mojo, you know, and there's only enough room for so many good teams in the Coastal Division, and when Pitt started getting good and getting above people, you know, obviously they had to get above certain teams, and NC State's one of the teams that they've been able to put in their rearview mirror, and I think that that's the challenge for NC State, is to get back to that level where they are making NCAA tournaments, and they are able to get results on the road at places like Pitt.
Lucchini was offside. And yeah, George Kiefer and the Wolfpack trying to return to form. His first 3 seasons with the Wolfpack. Back to 3 straight NCAA tournaments. You see the offside here. Called by the near side assistant referee.
You're not drawing me into those offside conversations tonight. Sorry.
Can't draw you in?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Maybe it is, maybe it's not.
This ball loose, and Hatzios comes out to snag it. There's been three straight tournament appearances for the Panthers and a drought of 3 years for NC State. But you do like some of the young talent for George Kiefer. A lot of freshmen and sophomores with a ton of upside. Here's one of them in Callum Tommy. Freshman midfielder.
Butte tried to play a delicate cross over there. It didn't quite come off, but you could see what he was trying to do. I mean, obviously, the last few years has been really disruptive for, I think, most teams, and the COVID situation didn't do favors for very many people. I do think Pitt was able to weather the storm as well as a lot of teams, but, you know, there's always turnover on your college rosters, and, you know, you can't just be perennially good, especially in the ACC. So, you know, it takes time to get your guys' experience, to bring in the type of people that you want, and to be able to build your team the way that you want it to be, and build your team culture. So all of those things take time. Coach Kiefer recognizes he has a mix of a young squad with some experience, and obviously he's vetting these young players, getting them experience right now. And, you know, they're in a lot of these games. They had some good ACC results last year, some strong draws. They beat Boston College, and you can see, you know, it's just a matter of doing it consistently. And I think you see this young NC State team finding their legs, gathering confidence, and, you know, they're going to be a thorn in a lot of teams' side throughout this ACC season, and they're certainly not going away tonight.
That's why Connor Kelly's been so important for NC State this year. 5 goals in 5 games. And had so much trouble scoring over the last few seasons. A lot of young talent. It's hard to score in this league and in college soccer in general, so having an older guy that can step in, provide leadership, help guys through situations, and then also score some goals is super helpful. I liked what George Kiefer told us about the Wake Forest loss, which was, you know, as tough of a loss as you're going to take. You go down a man 15 minutes in after the Batista red card, and Connor Kelly was kind of that calming force in the locker room, because George Kiefer said young guys can oftentimes get caught up in results, and that's all they think about. Connor Kelly's that older veteran that can say, hey, this game was always going to be tough. It's about us figuring things out as a unit as we move through this season. This one result doesn't mean anything for us.
Yeah, correct. And, I mean, this game right here, it's 1-0, and you got, you know, a good chunk of time left. So everything's to play for, and you have to maintain the right intensity and the right mental state. You can get an opportunity at any moment in time, and you keep fighting till the last second.
Here's Bautista. To Will Butte. And back out for Murray. So NC State looks to possess in the attacking half. Alex Bautista. Gives up possession to Valentin Noel. The Panthers have a rush. With a 1-0 lead, they'll settle it back at the midfield stripe.
Be interesting to see this second half chess match now. Pitt wanting to slow the game down. They'll be happy to possess, use all the space on the field. It's going to become harder for NC State to press the ball or chase it as much as they want. But you see there, just takes one opportunity, one missed touch. And the Wolfpack's right back in this game, so they'll keep looking for those opportunities. They may have to be a bit more careful in when they choose to press full on. But it's all about game management.
Syracuse up 2-1 on Clemson in the second half. North Carolina and Duke still tied up at 1. Louisville Boston College tied at 1.
Been trying to tell people about Syracuse. Look out for Syracuse.
You've been saying that for a couple seasons.
Yeah.
Like what they've done.
They're always a tough team to play against.
Five teams in the United Soccer Coaches top 25. Syracuse up to number 16. What is this tie business we got going on in the rankings these days? Pitt was tied for 10th last week. Wake Forest tied for second this week. Can't make decisions around here.
I'm not going to make a decision either. Here comes
Jackson. Turned away.
Pitt at 10's definitely played a tough start to the schedule. Started off with number 2, Georgetown. They played number 6, West Virginia. Played number 11, Marshall. So they came out of those games 2-1 and 4-1 on the start of the season. So I think it's been a really good start for Pitt. I think they'd generally be happy about where they are. Obviously, you never plan on losing any games, but to play a tough schedule like that right out the gate, I think is really impressive. You see right there, 11 out of 15 opponents were NCAA tournament teams last year. They've looked to test themselves out of the gate. I think that's one of the things Coach Vidovich has been happy about, is that they've been able to learn while winning.
That was Rosa looking for Lucchini again. Walty and Mirkovic. Back out wide to Rosa. Can he get the ball? He can keep it from crossing the end line. This one's tapped. Here's another header. Look at that! Josh Lucchini with a 2 spot on the board. That's a doubleheader game for Josh Lucchini.
Yeah, that's using your head all right. Loops it in. Very little power to it, but the angle's right. He just loops it over the goalie and into the far panel. You see the build-up play, all the same faces involved. Mirkovic is able to push it out. Lucas Rosa keeps it in. Picks out his delivery. High ball, Lucchini just loops it back over. Perfectly picked out. I mean, that's a tough break for NC State, but that is just measured out to perfection. It's a really good, that's a striker's goal, a goal scorer's goal. Looks like he's done that before. Pedregosa, nothing he can do about it. Just incredible placement.
So in one night, Josh Lucchini jumps up into second on the Pitt score sheet for the season. Lucas Rosa, his second assist of the year. Just a gorgeous play, and Josh Lucchini on the back end of 2 crosses with his head. And Pitt goes up 2-0.
That's a bit of a breakout game for Lucchini. Coming through some of those injuries, and now maybe he can establish himself in this Pitt lineup.
Lucchini joined the roster after 4 seasons at Lehigh, scored 25 goals in his Lehigh career, was a 2019 third-team All-American. Missed the first couple games of this season. This is his 5th game of the year. Started his last 2. Didn't start tonight, came on late first half, but he's the guy that accounted for the 2 goals on the board for the Panthers.
Yeah, he's been in the right place at the right time and known what to do with the ball both times, so credit to him. He's definitely a goal scorer's goal scorer. He's been doing it a long time. There's a lot to be said for that type of experience and having the poise to put the ball where you want it when it counts.
After the goal, Junior Nare back onto the pitch. Luke Hilly back on as well, trying to bring some offense.
Still everything to play for both teams. State looking to keep it tight. Lucchini's coming off, but he'll be lobbying to get back on the field and see if he can get a third, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Let's look for him getting in his coach's ear hole for the next 20 minutes.
4 career multi-goal games now for Lucchini in a coming out party as a Panther. Went to North Allegheny High School, just up the road in Wexford.
Tough break for NC State, but those are the challenges that the game provides, and they're really going to need to stay locked in and focused on this matchup. I think they've played very well. They've got a lot to be proud of in this game. Obviously, the result's not going the way they want, but I think that they're working extremely hard. Foul call goes against them there, but you can see they continue to press, continue to look to force turnovers and create opportunity for themselves. It's been a tall order for them tonight, but I think they've responded very well.
Card handed out to Jackson Waltze. So intense. Every time you take a camera shot of him, he's got something to say to somebody. Has no time for funny business.
Well, his coach described him as a beast this week. We were asking Coach Vidovich about him. You know, he says he hasn't missed a practice in 5 years, let alone a game. The door opened for him as a freshman, and he never let it shut. He was a walk-on. And he's essentially a poster child for this program. You talk about grit, he personifies grit, has a winning mentality, doesn't even like to lose a pickup game in practice. And I think that that's the type of stuff, that intensity that has an effect on a program. The younger guys feed off it. They see the expectation, the culture. Not just Waltie, but Berton Jackson, Valentin Noel, their willingness to work, train, put in the effort.
See Noah Hall commit the foul there. He's come on fresh for the Panthers. Noah Hall, Panthers right back in the future. Punched out by Vandersaar, had Wolfpack flying in there.
Vandersaar is impressive. He hasn't been called on a ton tonight, but whenever he's been called on, he's stepped up to the challenge. This is a big hand he gets on that ball. He's able to push it away for the corner. Good amount of pressure coming in there by NC State. You see there, Pedregosa's right behind him if he doesn't make that play.
Ball loose, Tommy lines it toward the net. And look at Vandersaar with a kick save. Still loose in the box. Gilman just barely over the end line. Another corner kick coming for NC State, but Vandersaar on it with the kick save.
Huge save. Callum Tommy gets the opportunity. The corner comes over, takes a slight deflection. He's able to control it and get the shot off, which is impressive. And Vandersaar with the big kick save.
There's Hilly off the volley just over the crossbar. So Vandersaar under a little bit of fire here.
That's the type of shot that can definitely cause you problems. Unfortunate for State not to get back in this game with that one, but that's what having Joe Vandersaar back there does for you. You need your keepers to make the save at the right time, especially if they haven't been particularly busy on that night. You know, you might just need that one save at that one moment, and that's what Vandersaar just did to stop the momentum from turning in this game.
There's Noah Hall trying to find some space, but it ends up at the feet of Noel.
Nice footwork by Noel there. Maintains possession for Pitt.
Touch there by Mirkovic and a turnover. Looking up the middle for Noel. So here comes NC State. Connor Kelly back with Callum Tommy. Had the best chance of the night for the Wolfpack by far. Just a few moments ago.
Important for Pitt to defend well right here. They've just had a scare. I think if you allow NC State to get on the scoreboard right here, it's going to be a really hectic last 15, whereas if you can hold them off the board, things will be a little bit more comfortable for you.
Shaka Son in space. Edwards over there with him. Lets it settle. Making a one-on-one move and knocked out by Edwards. Just a few moments ago, Vander Sar with that amazing kick save, David. He knows a little something about goalkeeping. Father Edwin, four-time Premier League champion. Great relationship between those two. Joe played for Edwin's club for a few seasons before coming over to Pitt.
Edwin van der Sar, the CEO of Ajax right now in the Dutch league. Obviously played for Man United and Fulham and Juventus, Ajax. Great career, and now he's moved up to the front office. Makes it all the more interesting what Joe van der Sar will choose to do with his future. Obviously has great upbringing and has been around the game his whole life.
It's his first full college season. He was on the team last year, but was kind of buried on the depth chart because of Nico Campuzano, who was a sixth-year player and keeper for Pitt last season. But you talk about some of the confidence that Van der Sar exudes. You think some of that comes from, you know, being around European players like his dad, in that culture, understanding what it's all about. And ever since he's stepped between the pipes this season, David, he just seems to have this energy about him where nothing really gets him off. He's a leader back there for this team.
Yeah, I mean, you have to have confidence as a goalkeeper. You got to really work to make sure that your head's in the game and that you're picking up everyone around you, that you're instilling confidence in the back line in front of you, calling out direction. For Van der Sar to put up three shutouts already this season, been a really impressive start, and I think has helped solidify Pitt's back line.
A back line that was totally replaced this year, including the goalkeeper. So your back five totally replaced, and Pitt with three shutouts on the year, working on a fourth. Off the restart, easy possession taken away by Pitt, and here's Jacques Son leaking out once again.
This
Noel sprinting up the center of the field. Jacques Son was looking for him, but Noel was heading back post. Idol Sefcetti came on just a few moments ago. Fairleigh Dickinson transfer, a grad student for the Panthers, number 15 in white. Here he is, the ball at his feet, and he earns a corner.
Sefcetti actually Italian, bringing a different element to this team, along with all the Frenchmen. Nice through ball there by Noah Hall. He's able to stretch the line and win the corner. Pitt's starting to use some of their depth tonight. Good opportunity to look at some other players and rest some legs. Keep the pressure on NC State.
Okay, Son looking back post, headed out by NC State. Pitt with 14 shots tonight. Jacques Son leaving it for Noah Hall.
Pitt coming in with 17 shots a game average. So they're a couple off that pace right now, but they're definitely sniffing for more. Continuing to ask questions of this NC State back line.
Jay Vidovich sitting on 99 career conference wins. Pitt holds this result. Jay Vidovich would become the first coach in ACC history to reach 100 conference wins.
That'd be quite an accomplishment for him. I know that's something that'd make him very proud.
Rosa with Hall. Hall trying to chip it in front of the net, and there's Hatzios.
Hatzios has done well. I really think he's done a lot of good things to keep NC State in this game, give his team a chance to win and get a result. Nice combination play there between Noel and Rosa. Rosa's another guy that's made a big impact on this team. Good experience, a settling force. Great passing ability.
It's Mike Sullivan. Cecchetti toward the goal. Just deflected and cleared out.
That's a great block. Pitt continuing to turn the screws on NC State, ask more and more questions. Cecchetti, he's going to end up getting the shot. Noel plays it through. Sullivan combines with Cecchetti. Sullivan with the ball across. The goalie. Andrew goes to combine to block it.
With the week of training the Panthers had, Jay Vidovich told us that Idol Cecchetti earned a spot. Said he's a heck of a competitor, and he really made training valuable for the team this week. So he earns himself some time in an ACC game.
If there's one thing we've heard Coach Vidovich talk about the last 4 years, it's about earning the jersey. And every one of these Pitt guys understands what that means. Giving everything for the team, being selfless, putting the team above yourself, doing your job.
The two goals in the game so far brought to you by Josh Lucchini. Couple of headers for the hometown kid.
Heads it down off a free kick for that one. Opens his Pitt account. Just a few minutes later, gets a second. Just a dirty loop and header. Freezes the goalie just over Pedregoso. Tough one to give up for State. But could be a backbreaker. We'll see.
Well, he's back out on the field, so he's got 9 minutes here, 8 minutes, excuse me, to try and get a hat trick. Fourth career multi-goal game. Has two career hat tricks as a member of Lehigh, one in 2019 and another in 2021 in the COVID season.
It's going to be really important that Pitt is able to maintain this result as is, keep the clean sheet, keep your cushion. And while it'd be nice for Lucchini to get a hat-trick, I'm sure that's not their major thought right now. It's going to be holding on to this ball, knocking it around the park.
It might be Lucchini's thought.
Oh, it's definitely Lucchini's thought.
Lucchini slots into that nine spot where Valentin Noel was running around all night. Will Butte also exited. Plamana back on. Cisneros has come on for NC State. Jonathan Cisneros, the freshman, number 20 in black.
I'll say it again. I think there's a ton to be gained for this Wolfpack squad coming out of this game. If the result holds, they can hold their head up high. They've worked extremely hard. I think they've had some success.
Centered up. Once again, Hatzios is there. Sullivan had a good chance. Panthers love what Michael Sullivan brings to the table. Local kid as well out of Deer Lakes High School. Won a Whippeal title in this area. Jay Vinovich told us in the offseason Sullivan's one of our favorites, especially among the local products. Right outside the box, there's a foul. It'll be a free kick for the Panthers. Bertan Jacquesson has also exited the ball game.
Batista making the case that he won the ball.
think he might have a case.
Yeah, he got his toes to it.
Mateo Maiufo got the start tonight, his first career. Had a game winner last week against North Carolina. He's over the ball, along with Lucas Rosa. Rosa toward the net. Look at that, he bangs it in. Lucas Rosa, make it 3-0 Panthers. Second goal of the year for Lucas Rosa, former NEC Player of the Year at St. Francis.
Bangs in off the post. Gives the Panthers the cushion they need. You see there's a gap in the wall. He goes right through it. Turns it in off the post. Callum Tom, he looks like he kind of ducks under it a little bit. That's not really what you're looking for from the wall, but... You know, and again, NC State's done well tonight. Obviously, there's some things they'd like to have done better. I think it's a bit flattering on Pitt to say 3-0, although they've had more shots. I think NC State's really done a good job of defending their goal. But these Panthers just don't go away. And if you give them opportunities, they will continue to put them away.
Entered halftime scoreless. Panthers struck quickly. The 47th minute, just a couple minutes after we resume play. Josh Lucchini with his first of two headers. Then in the 69th minute, Lucchini with another one. And now in the 85th, Lucas Rosa gives the Panthers a 3-0 score over NC State. NC State now outshot in their last two ACC games, 32-5. And there's your summary for the evening. Lucas Rosa has been a heck of an addition to this roster as well, David, sliding into that right back position that was held by Jasper Loffelsen a season ago.
Yeah, and it's really an attacking right back position, so you have the freedom to get up the field and jump into the attack and play on quite a lot of opportunities. Rosa's perfect for that role. He is an attacking player, and so it's sort of like you got another midfield type forward jumping up from right back position, and the experience and the talent is just enabling Pitt to turn the screws on this Wolfpack team tonight.
Pitt now with three or more goals in 17 of its last 26 home games. Mentioned earlier that under Jay Vidovich, Panthers are 54-6-2 when they score first. Of course, they've done that tonight. They are unbeaten since the start of 2020 when they score first.
I mean, it's just mesmerizing to watch them play at home. You know, I mean, they're so good here. Obviously, they get great crowds behind them. But there's something about this place, whether it's the field or just the home cooking or how comfortable these players are. They really do a good job here, and they are extremely tough to beat.
The crowds have been electric this season as well. Had the largest crowd in program history in the season opener against Georgetown, which was 2-7 in the rankings nationally. Panthers won that one. The number that jumps out to me at home, David, is now it's a plus 66 goal differential at home since the start of the 2019 season.
Yeah, they're just dominant. Obviously, they like playing on this turf. Get it away!
But I think one thing, David, to note about tonight that's impressive is, of course, Jackson and Noel, and we talk about them all we want to, and everyone should. Noah Hall here with a chance, bouncing around and cleared out. But on your bingo card, did you have two goals from Josh Lucchini and one from Lucas Rosa?
I did not.
I didn't either, and I think that tells you something about what this roster's doing, and maybe it builds on what Jay Vidovich told us coming into this game. This week of training was perfect, is basically what he was telling us. It energized the team. They found good things happening. They had opportunity to rest certain guys. Now they come into tonight, and it's not even the stars that are necessarily jumping out at you. It's some of those other guys that are finding their way into the mix. Two transfers into the program account for all three goals tonight.
Yeah, it's a sign of the growing squad. again, coming into this season, you know, only 9 of the 27 had pulled on a Pitt shirt before. So you have two-thirds of your squad are brand new to the program. And I think that there was a lot of unknowns coming into the season for this Pitt team. But again, I think it shows you what the leadership's done, what the culture of the team is, how the young players and the transfers have been able to come in and jump right into the process, understand what they're all about, what the expectations are, what you have to do to earn the jersey.
Looking ahead for the Panthers, doesn't get any easier. They have number 14 Akron on this field on Monday. Might be one of their toughest tests of the season, playing that game only 3 days after playing an ACC game on a Friday night. And then next Friday, they go down to Louisville to face the Cardinals. So 3 games in 7 days, starting with tonight's game against the Wolfpack.
Yeah, we'll be here on Monday night for the Akron game. Akron's no joke. I watched them play out a 3-3 draw with Ohio State the other night. I think it was Tuesday night, and they've been off since then. So Akron's sitting at home watching this, preparing for Pitt, and that'll be a big non-conference game on Monday night up here on the hill.
Jackson Walty with a bit of a curtain call as he exits the game. And for NC State, they go back to the drawing board, but they were excited for it. George Kiefer told us, hey, I'm excited to have 2 straight weeks with no midweek games. So they get a week to prepare for Virginia Tech and another week after that to prepare for Louisville, both of them at home. So they do it in the friendly confines of Raleigh.
Yeah, and I think they'll have a ton of positives to take out of this game. It was always going to be a tough matchup for them. Brilliant first half. I think they really did a lot to ask a lot of questions for Pitt and create chances themselves. Second half, I think you saw Pitt's experience, tenacity, energy kind of raise the stakes of the game another notch. And I think that was the difference in the game, where Pitt was really able to take it to another gear, another level, to raise the energy. And they have themselves a win as a result.